All right, we are live. This is the first Franchise Freedom live podcast. We're going to hold off for a second and build up an audience, making sure everyone gets the alert. Mike, welcome to the show. We'll do a formal intro.
Thanks. It's an honor to be on the show, number one, but number two on the first live one. That's awesome.
This is great. So we're testing out the system. We are on I don't know if I mentioned this, Facebook, LinkedIn, and YouTube. So looking forward, we are going to also be replying to comments, which we'll probably hold off towards the end of the show. And if anything is missed, we will definitely make sure to get back to anyone that had a question or comment. So we'll hold off here a few more seconds. Let's see here. Okay. All right, I think we'll get started, and then I don't know if you see comments on your end, but I'm sure I'll see them on mine. So we'll get started. All right, so welcome to the Franchise Freedom Podcast. I'm your host, Giuseppe Grammatico, your franchise guide, and today we have a very special guest. Today we are speaking with Mike Saunders, and before I even get into the show, Mike has been generous. You know, we had recorded this show a few months ago. And due to a new platform we were using, did not realize the video was only on the host for a few weeks. So definitely learning here, and we'll probably do maybe a whole show on going live as we're figuring things out. So Mike, welcome to the show.
Hey, thanks, Giuseppe. And you know, I think the last time when we spoke, we were talking previous to recording about green screen and lighting. So maybe yes. There should be like a tech show that you should do just to go, here's some tech tips learned from mistakes that I've personally made and some lessons learned.
Yes, exactly. No, absolutely. I'm learning as we're going. I did not purchase the lighting you had recommended yet, but I do have that Amazon listing and should be purchasing that this week. Was experimenting with a few things. So let me give a little bit of your bio here. And if anyone has any questions, we'll definitely answer them towards the end of the show, unless it has something to do with just something Mike has just been talking about. And if we don't get to your comments or questions, we will definitely get back to you via email or some way or another. So we do appreciate that. Little bio, Mike, on Mike Saunders, of authority positioning coach, a speaker, best-selling author of 4 books, and a successful business coach who holds an MBA in marketing. Mike is also an adjunct marketing professor at several universities and a member of the Forbes Coaches Council. He has interviewed hundreds of industry experts on his podcast and is always striving to learn from other thought leaders. Mike is most passionate about seeing his family grow up with high spiritual values and providing them opportunities to succeed in life. Once again, welcome to the show, and looking forward to this one because I learned a lot for my business, and looking to get the word out and help as many people as possible. So thanks again.
Hey, you're welcome.
So, you know, tell us a little bit about just, you know, how did you get into the, you know, a little bit of a background. How did you get into the business you're currently in right now?
Well, the business I'm currently in, which is marketing consulting, would be the broad term. And I'll tell you the big mistake I made there in just a second. But I spent about 11 years in the mortgage banking industry way back in the day. So from like 99 to 2010. And if you remember the dates in U.S. history, boy, there was a little bit of a blip in the economic outlook during like 07, 08, 09, 10. I mean, it just kept on and on. So when the crash happened, you know, my business just evaporated. I was working for a major bank and it just went away. So I went back to school and did my MBA in marketing. And through one of the courses, it was like a business plan course, pick a business you'd like to start and write a business and marketing plan. So you're working through that. And I was like, well, I love marketing. So I built a marketing plan and a business plan on starting my own firm. And through the research there, connected up with the Small Business Development Centers in Denver here, SBDC. And if you're not familiar with them, boy, they're really a source of just a wealth of knowledge, of free information and free consulting. So they gave me some information for my business plan. And then they called back and were like, hey, can you do some consulting for us? And so I was like, yeah, that'd be fun. Mm-hmm. And then from there with the business plan, you know, I was like, that business plan seemed to, you know, be really neat. So I launched my business and started picking up clients. And of course, during the economic crash and downturn, it's not, you know, it was really hard, but I started picking up enough clients to go, ooh, this is really neat. Now, the mistake I made that I alluded to is because I was new, I was trying to do anything and everything for anybody. Right. And that's the mistake, because if you're not laser focused on what you do, people don't view you as a trustworthy, reliable expert, right? They're just like, oh, you do everything. Well, you and I both, Giuseppe, get emails and phone calls from people from all over the world. Oh, your Google listing is your SEO, and you just ignore it. But you know that they charge rock bottom prices and somebody takes them up on that offer. So I was lumped into all of that. So about 6 years ago, I refocused my business, you know, and I call myself a recovering marketing consultant because I am a marketing consultant, right. But I focus on one thing, helping business owners and entrepreneurs and coaches and speakers and authors be seen as that expert authority and really create their celebrity status in their niche, in their industry, not necessarily geographic. That's fine. And also on the other hand, not necessarily a CNN talking head. That's a whole different level. You know, you'd pay someone 10 grand a month as a PR agency to get you that level, but creating your own expertise in the pond that you fish in so that people see you as that expert and that go-to and that trusted advisor. So that's how I got into the industry that I'm in. And then that's the focus that I focus on for the last 5 or 6 years.
Right. That's awesome. And that is an area. I think there's right now, I think there's just information overload and, you know, with the internet or actually going back to the pandemic, right. A lot of us are working from home where you know, people didn't know what Zoom was 12 months ago, and now they're using it on a daily basis. We're utilizing StreamYard right now. And, you know, how do you grab people's attention? And not only that, you grab people's attention. Great. Maybe you have an interesting post, but how do you create that? You know, we talk about authority positioning. How do you create that omnipresence so that they're seeing you? You know, they're like, wow, okay. You know, I saw Mike on the podcast and I just read his book. He was a guest on someone else's podcast. Talk to us a little bit more about that. So what, you know, authority positioning, it sounds to me, what, you know, just from the outside and obviously I know what it is, but since we've had this conversation before, but what does it look like? Are there certain pillars, certain steps that you like to kind of cover? Because from the outside, it just sounds like just appear everywhere, but that's obviously not the case. So can you talk to us a little bit more about that?
Yeah, well, omnipresence is what I would recommend you do step two or three. Because omnipresence is just like how it sounds, being present and seen everywhere. And yeah, that's good. But I feel like if people are looking to amplify and optimize their business development, they will get, you know, kind of like deer in the headlights.
Right.
If you start talking to them about all the things they need to do all the time. So what I like to do is just say, look, here's what authority marketing is, authority positioning is. And let's put together a package that I do for you. You don't need to do it or learn it. It's just, you need to know what the concept is and I'm going to hand it to you. And then this is not something where you're going to eliminate everything you're currently doing and now do this. Authority marketing literally is an overlay over what you currently are doing so that it makes what you're currently doing more effective. And so it literally is taking who you are and what you do and putting it on platforms of trust. And it's really as simple as that. So think of it like this, whatever industry or business that you're in and whatever problem you solve for your target audience,
right?
That's really at the core of everything is that's what business and marketing is. I solve problems. Oh, you're a whatever, you know, a customer that has this problem. I've got the solution and I've spent 5 years focusing on the solution. Here's what I recommend. So however you articulate that solution to that problem is how people will perceive you. Now, let's think of it like this. You could write an article. And way back in the day, you'd write articles and get them submitted to article directories. Mm-hmm. And nowadays, that's not really, you know, a good strategy. But if you wrote an article and you got that out to your target audience, they'd glance at it.
Right.
But they know it's like a Word doc or a PDF doc. It's like, eh, whatever. And then if you put it on your website, oh, okay, that might get a little bit different or more interest. But I know your website, you just go publish and save. And so the barrier to entry there is not that strong. Right. And we could think of a lot of different examples of that. But that one, you know, a piece of content, the solution to one aspect of that problem, where else can you get it? And where would it be seen where people sit up and take notice and go, oh, okay, hold up. I get all these things flying at me, you know, emails and text and but hold on. This was an article published on Forbes. I'm going to check that one out, or I'm going to bookmark that one and read that one a little bit later. Or, this guy, here's an example. I'm sitting here with, you know, a copy of my latest book, Brevity Plus Clarity Equals Authority. So if I were to drop this in the mail to you and go, hey, you know what, Giuseppe, I really enjoyed chatting with you the other day. Looking forward to connecting next week when we go a little bit deeper. But I thought you'd like to read it from my book here. And also, I did this podcast episode on this podcast, and I talk a lot about the principles in there. Here's the link too. And you might get that. And are you going to read every single word of this? Most people will not. But I will tell you that my proprietary process I call Brevity Book. Right. This is meant to be read in one sitting. And you get your main content out and people get it. But where I'm going with that is that same thought, leadership, intellectual property, solution to that problem, if it's in that book, now it's way different than the four blog posts that you could have put it on.
Right.
And so I think that's what you need to think about is what do you do and what do you know that solves problems for your target audience? And it might be the same solution to the problem, but you come about it in a different way, or you've got a life experience or a business experience that brings a different flavor. So, you know, there's nothing new under the sun, as Ecclesiastes teaches in scripture. There's really, you know, these days it's like marketing. Well, okay, you can have bots in this, but in reality, how can we stand out in an instant? Because we're all distracted with technology. So how could we stand out in an instant? And I will submit to you that when people see you, your brand, your personal brand, as authoritative and expert-like, and they see you as that celebrity, and it might be, oh, you were interviewed on, or oh, you interviewed an influencer on your podcast, or you have this book, or you were mentioned in the media. Now they sit up and take notice. Now, does that mean they, you know, blindly follow you and go, here's my credit card, take all my money? No, but it gets you an at bat. And the at bat is being able to speak with them in person, phone, Zoom, whatever the case is, and learn a little bit more. And now when you're speaking to them, they're not viewing you as a pushy salesperson. Right. They're viewing you as, oh, Giuseppe, you know, I got that book and I listened to that podcast and yeah, I've got some questions I want to ask you. And I've had this happen so many times where they jump right into detailed questions because they read over my book. They listened through my podcast episodes. And I say over and through because don't kid yourself, you know, this is not a really thick book. It's not 400 pages, but they still aren't going to read every word of it. And, you know, a couple of podcast episodes, they still aren't going to listen to every single syllable of it. But the fact that you have them, it sets you apart. Now, once you establish that, now you can keep moving forward and keep doing it over and over. Now, having one book, one podcast episode, one mentioned in the media, you check those boxes and that's wonderful. It's better than your competition, but you can't stop there. It can't be like, oh, well, Giuseppe, it looks like you had that interview back in, you know, 2018. Mm-hmm. Well, you got to keep it up.
Right. Yeah, I couldn't agree more. And one thing I'll add, because, you know, I'm working on that myself, you know, trying to figure out how to stand out. And, you know, I go back. So a little kind of a thing I did the other day was there's certain emails that I get that I really look forward to. They grab my interest, but they stand out in one way or another. And sometimes I just can't place my finger on it. So I backtrack to see, okay, you know, what is it? Did that person, for example, one individual, we had a conversation. We ended up, you know, just becoming good friends, never became actually a client, wasn't an exact fit for what we did, but had him on the show. He sent me his book. It was great. I have recommended him to a dozen other people in that particular industry that he's in because, you know, I look forward to his emails. The information is really good. It's quick and to the point. And if you want more information, he leaves it open to a phone call. So, but I kind of look back and just to see what are other people doing? Why am I so interested in this person's email or this person's content? So, it's a practice that I've been slowly kind of reverse engineering the process to figure out, you know, what is it that, you know, originally kind of caught my attention. So, really, really good stuff there. So I did get, where was it here? I did get an email this morning, someone that could not make the event. And they are asking, because I work with people in career transition. So this individual is not a business owner yet. They are looking to leave their, I'm looking at the email here, leave their full-time job and potentially invest in a franchise. And we've been, you know, having a few conversations. So does this work for an employee or someone that has no interest in becoming a business owner, or they, you know, maybe they have a job and they freelance on the side? Does this apply to someone that's really not a business owner?
The answer is yes. And I'll answer it by giving a preface it with a story slash example. Okay. And book recommendation. Have you, Giuseppe, ever read the book called Built to Last?
I have not.
You should. I love it. It's really great. It's written in fictional storybook format. And basically the gist of it is, here's this business owner guy that owns a graphic design company and he hates it. He's getting working 9,000 hours a day and people pull him in all these directions. And so he calls this business consultant, goes, help me sell my dumb business. I want to get out. And they're right. Like, okay, let's talk. And he goes, look, you're just all over it. You're not saleable yet. So why don't we get some polish this thing up and get it to the point of where you can sell it at a good rate. And one of the ways that they do that is they say, what are you really good at? Cause you do business cards and graphics and logos and website. And he goes, well, you know what? We really do logos really well. He goes, okay, right. Don't do anything else. Just do logos. Let's be the best logo builder ever. And he resisted a little bit, but then he did it. And now, you know, whatever, 6 months later, he is now cranking out logos, charging the highest price. People are loving it. He's loving his business. And he decides, maybe I don't want to sell. The reason I bring that up is the answer is authority positioning most definitely works for someone in career. I'm going to tell you exactly how. And maybe the byproduct of doing this could mean, you know what? Maybe I'm going to stay in that career just a little bit longer. Right. And maybe guess what? Here's the beautiful thing. Today, when you look at buying a business or starting your own business, you don't need to quit your job right away. You can do, you put one foot in one side of the equation. So now what if you're looking at, okay, you know what? I'm getting a lot of fulfillment out of my career. I'm not quite ready to quit just yet, but I did enough research on this franchise that I'm going to bring in my best friend, relative, my business, whatever. And we're going to do this together so that I'm kind of the, you know, co-CEO, and I'm going to put in, you know, nights and weekends, but here's this person running it. And then when I am ready to leave the corporate world, then I've got this smooth transition, and maybe you're giving your, you know, business partner opportunity as well. And maybe it grows in other locations. So what I'm saying is you can have the best of both worlds. So here's how it could work for someone in a job right now. Let's just say that you're in VP level and you want to get up to the next level or CEO level or whatnot. And can you imagine the HR person, the hiring manager, getting a proverbial stack of resumes this thick? Now, these days it's like emails, right? Right. But, you know, emails, this many emails, you know, all these emails you're reviewing, it's like, oh, they all look the same. And what would happen if, you know, applicant A, our person in this example, sends this resume, and maybe it's a nice resume, but there's this introduction paragraph or maybe even a box that goes, as you review this resume, please click here to view the applicant interview on this podcast where they talk about their competitive advantage, where they took this company from this sales to that. And now here's this hiring manager going, hold up. They were interviewed on a pod and they were mentioned in the media, and who knows, maybe if it's a high level job, maybe they wrote a brief little book on, right, you know, the ins and outs of, right. And how, you know, this industry can. And so now here's this job applicant that is seen as really a expert and authority in that realm. Now, does that guarantee them the job? Nope. Because they still might not be able to back up what they did. They might not interview well. And right. But the point is, I'll bet you it takes their resume from mid to up to the top, yeah, and it will increase the chance of them getting that interview a lot more. And I will tell you this, whether you're an entrepreneur, business owner, or in this case, an employee, when you start taking what's in your head and talking about it and getting mentioned and getting interviewed, and you see those things out there, and the interviewer sends you the link, and, you know, hey, Giuseppe, our podcast interview just went live, and here's the link. And it's like, wow, that turned out great with a nice intro. And your confidence levels increase. Right. So now when you go in for that interview, you go in walking a little bit more tall and a little bit more confident because you've kind of go, you know what? I kind of do have the chops. And so I would answer that question by saying most definitely yes. But if you find that you get that next level job and still have that entrepreneurial hankering, boy, right, this day and age where we're in today, you can get into that franchise, and maybe even your expertise in the business world maybe even gives you a leg up in getting the maybe, who knows, maybe it's a really hot franchise and people are like, I don't know, let's, you know, we want to just choose the best franchise ease, and maybe that also helps you get that. But then you bring in a business partner, and now you've got two things going for you. Right. You're a little bit more resolved in your career, and now you've got the franchise. And what a piece that gives you to go, okay, I like my job a little bit more, and my business partner and I are building a franchise on the side here. And if I ever want to leave, or I ever, you know, the company gets taken over, I've got a backup plan and a safety net.
Wow. That's excuse me. Some great takeaways. I never looked at it as far as the job applicant goes. That's very interesting, because they are, you know, HR is looking at a sea of resumes. First thing they do is they look to LinkedIn, and I see people not even putting their photos on there. So there's courses, free classes, obviously, it's just to clean up your LinkedIn, to really stand out. But you made a very good point. You know, that positioning, being on a podcast, writing doesn't have to be a huge book. It could be an ebook. It could be just a small, you know, I have a small book. It's probably about a 30-40 minute read. And, I know that you're definitely going to stand out with that. So some really good points I never even thought of. And I think we can do, so we have two ideas for shows, what to do, what not to do by, you know, all of my mistakes on the podcast, kind of figuring this out. So how to launch your show, and then, you know, how to get hired, I think is.
Or how to get that C-level promotion, right? You know, because, like, for instance, how to get hired, you know, if you're going in for a lower level and you talk about podcast and they're like, what? But maybe how to get the higher level C-level, C-suite jobs, they want that. They expect that. And maybe that is a unique differentiator. And, you know, I kind of feel like that, you know, that might be like a secret weapon that you do to get that job. And then you don't tell anybody about it because it's like, you know, you don't want your coworkers you know, seeing that. But yes, all you care about is that hiring manager and the upper level management C-suite to go, there's just something about this person. And you took that initiative and you've got that, you know, drive, and we like that. Right. So I think that's just a really neat consideration.
Yeah. I definitely like that. I couldn't agree more. And with the internet nowadays, you know, the articles, obviously you can't stop at one, but it's there, you know, utilize it. And, you know, the thing we talked about is even repurposing, right? I mean, there's only so much time in the day. I record, you know, multiple podcasts. I have my own show. I'm a guest. I was a guest on your show. So, you know, how do we repurpose this? And so we're reaching maybe different audiences. I work with corporate execs, first time business owners, which sometimes end up business owners, it maybe isn't the right fit. They just kind of wanted to explore it. It was always on the back of their mind, and they figured they'd reach out. So, I think that's huge. So, anyway, I wanted to switch gears and make sure we kind of cover everything. Repurposing of content is obviously probably, unless you wanted to touch on something that's something I'm learning about and I'm trying to improve, unless there's something you wanted to touch on with repurposing, but I think instead of constantly creating that new content, utilizing what you have. So did you want to touch or comment on anything?
I will just say repurposing is essential, and that ties into omnipresence, and it also ties into efficiency. Right. Because if you do that one thing, whatever that thing is, right? That thought leadership interview on a podcast,
right?
You can repurpose that into so many other things so that you get more bang for that one action that you did. And then that helps open the door for that omnipresence. And let's use it as an example. If you did, like, for instance, this podcast interview, we're doing video at the moment, but don't you know that you can extract out the audio and you can now get that out to audio platforms and put that on your website. And you can take this video and put that on your website, your social media. You can have this transcribed yourself, you know, like, hey, I was a guest on, so transcribe it and then clean it up and put some paragraph headings and images. Right. And now that becomes an article, blog post, a long form Facebook post. So now that ties into omnipresence, because now someone might not have seen you on this podcast video, but they saw that Facebook post that you did. Well, how did you think, you know, let me think of what to type here. No. So many times there's a disconnect between your head and your hands, whether it's writing or typing. So you could speak your expertise and, wow, I did that great interview. Too bad I couldn't have written. Well, transcribe it, article, Facebook, Instagram, whatever the case is, take little snippets of it, you know, do shoot, you know, break it into two or three. So that ties into being efficient, and also omnipresence, and being repurposing the same thing multiple times. And then guess what? I'll leave it with this. Let's say that you did an interview on topic A, whatever that topic is, and you did all the things we just mentioned. Well, don't you think that in like a month or two, you can just repost it out there? Because do you think that you posted one thing on your social media platform and every single person that follows you saw it? Nope. So you don't want to post it every other second, but what if every couple, 3 months you go back through and you say, hey, you know, here's an idea that I did, you know, you can be honest about it. Hey, here's a great idea. You know, I came across this where I talked about this one thing and it's really, really great solution to this. And just thought you might well like to check it out again. Here it is. I mean, so you just keep recycling that through, but that's a really good point that you bring up, is repurposing content.
Yeah. And I mean, I couldn't agree more, and I'm doing more and more of it. I've noticed the number of downloads, people listening to the show has literally tripled since last year. So, not a huge number yet, and we're working our way up, but we've noticed literally a tripling, a triple of a number of viewers and downloads. So, and we do things, so an audiogram, something simple. So they get it, or maybe it's the three key takeaways. So it resonates with people. So am I going to invest 30 minutes into listening to this show? What are the takeaways, so that I know to watch it maybe later? So, but to your point, yes, not everyone sees it on the first post. So there's even software that I've come across that will repost it, or kind of they do, you know, almost like a random repost where every, you know, 4 to 6 weeks it just gets reposted again, just in case you missed it, and it reposts. Yep. So it's not that you're running out of ideas, but I mean, at the end of the day, we are a lot of the things we are saying are very similar. I know with every candidate we talk to, and we talk about business ownership, the principles are the same. You know, why do you want a business? What's your motivations? Forget about picking a franchise is simple, but why do you want to get into this? And is franchising the right fit, or is it a startup business? Is it both? Is it keeping your job? There's so many different.
And let's say you pick a franchise, and depending on the one, you know, this is just an idea, but you use their marketing plan. And of course, that's one of the benefits, is let's give me the proven success step. So I'm going to do that. But maybe there's some authority positioning that can be overlaid into that same marketing plan with approval. So do whatever needs to be done. But what would happen if you went to your, you know, franchisor and asked the permission and said, hey, you know what? In our market, as you know, it's a lot of educating the target audience on our thing, whatever this is that we're doing. So I'd love to just start a podcast and just bring this teaching and learning in front. You know, would that be all right? They're going to go yes, or whatever they're going to. So all of these same authority positioning platforms and tools and techniques, do it within your franchise, because many times, if you've noticed on Shark Tank, many times it's like, we got to educate people on this. They don't really know it right off. So if you are in an industry where the franchise, the target audience is such that you should be educating them, why not have, you know, your own podcast? Why not pick 5 to 7 pillar pieces of content learning objectives that once your target audience understands those 5 to 7 things, they fully understand what you do. Right. They come to you to ask for more, and it becomes a customer/client. If that's the case, you just keep pounding those from different angles on your podcast. You interview experts about those same things. And then guess what you do? You take the best interviews, maybe even with an influencer, and you transcribe those and talk about repurposing. Why don't you take those 5 to 7, and that becomes 5 to 7 chapters of your book, and you get a graphic designer. And now you, again, if it's in your franchise, you all get all approval and send it, whatever you need to do. But now you've got a book. I've heard of HVAC, you know, heating and air contractors that have their own book, and they leave that behind when they go do a big estimate. And I've heard, I mean, who would have thought that? That's a blue collar job. Mm-hmm. But there, all of these authority positioning tools and strategies, just because you're with a franchise and they have their tried and true, doesn't mean you shirk that, but this could be a nice supplement to that.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Couldn't agree more. Obviously, with any business, I mean, obviously with the franchise, each company is different. Some will handle the marketing, but I don't see why it would be an issue. Where I see the huge opportunities, that we have a lot of B2B, small business coaching, expense reduction, franchises, and things like
tax
that.
Tax prep, yeah.
A lot of assets are created for you, but it's up to you to actually put it out on social media and how you want to run with it. If it's a webinar, if it's a live presentation, you know, whatever the case may be. So really good stuff. So here's the thing. So I've owned multiple businesses in the past, and I think, and I want to talk more about your business and how, and who is your ideal client and how you're able to help them. So I've seen this. So sometimes we get information overload, right? You know, we talk about the need for a business coach because they hold us accountable. They remind us, it's like, all right, I have a call with a coach. I better have some progress, or, you know, I know they're going to really beat me up on this phone call. So I know personally for me, I started to absorb all this great stuff on marketing and social media. And then when it comes to apply it, you're just completely overwhelmed. Maybe you're not sure where to start. So, you know, where does your company come in? Do you offer options where you're advising, you're doing it for the client, a hybrid approach? Maybe you're kind of combining it, because I notice where a lot of my colleagues, they drop off as they have this great stuff. I'm part of an accountability group. We share these ideas, but I don't see a lot of us, including myself in many cases, moving forward with it, because you're like, okay, it sounds good in concept, but how the heck do I do it? So
yeah,
I know I asked a lot, but I guess maybe if you can talk us through ideal client, what you offer and the options you offer, you know, to an ideal client. I guess we'll start there.
Yeah. That's a great point, because it's similar to the concept of knowledge is power. People go, oh yeah, knowledge is power, but wrong. Knowledge is potential power. You got to do something with it. So all of this, you know, you can listen to this or watch this presentation and what we're saying, Giuseppe, and authority marketing makes sense. I want to stand out. Yay. But what do I do? I don't know where to start.
Right.
And I could say, oh, I've got a 12-week, you know, group coaching, and you learn all these modules, and you wouldn't get past week two, and then you wouldn't even do it. So right. I kind of took over the years, come to the point where I feel like people are not lazy, but busy, mm-hmm. right? So they need to know. So I work with a lot of CEOs. Like, I just hung up with one on Friday before last. I delivered this big package to him, and then now I've been working with his marketing admin, because I did an hour presentation, Zoom screen share, showed him all of the deliverables.
Right.
I went through the marketing strategy guide for how to implement each one of these authority positioning assets mm-hmm. into his business. So he knew, he understood. He's like, okay, good. I like that one. Okay, that's good. But now he doesn't need to do it. He takes that recorded video that I did for the coaching session right. and the marketing strategy guide, hands it to his marketing person, and now she implements. But yeah. if you don't have a marketing person, mm-hmm. the point is, I have done for you packages. And I say, oh, you know where you need to do, get on a podcast, and you need to, I'll do it for you. You just sit back and I'll get your approvals. It's not going to, you know, surprise you and go, wait, hold on a second. So I do everything with you / for you. You're not doing the work. You're just approving. And then I coach you on how to actually implement it in what you're already doing to make it really easy, so that you're not starting from scratch. So the momentum is going and you're getting excited because you see, oh, wait a minute. You interviewed me on those three topics we talked about, and then you did a press release and I approved it, and then you got it out into syndication, and then you showed me how to get it out there and use it in my marketing. Wow. So now what can we do? Well, you know how fun it was to be on my show, and we talked about those really three really big things. You know, there's like 300 things we could talk about your business, and there's influencers you could reach out to and really connect and make strategic alliances. Why don't we get you launch your own show, and I'll do all the work. And then I'll show you and teach you how to get, reach out to those influencers and just chat with them. And then when you're done with the interview, wow, you've got another interview episode. They enjoyed it. They right. appreciate it. And then now the door's open for you to reconnect with them at the, you know, maybe the next week and go, hey, I've got an idea for you. And now you're getting strategic alliance networking. You can do the same thing with prospects. Right. You know, so like in your example, you just said, what if there's a franchise you want to buy for tax prep? Well, you know, after tax season, but you know, when you're looking for building your business, you want to go talk to CEOs of small to mid-sized businesses, right? Right. Well, you certainly shouldn't probably go say, you need taxes done. I do them. Great. Let's talk. Here's the link to buy. No, right. But how do you get the audience with that CEO? Maybe you reach out to them and interview them on your podcast, and they really appreciate the you know, spotlight and visibility, and you send them the link and a nice little graphic after, hey, thanks, Giuseppe. It was really great having you on my show. Here's the episode, and I put it on my social media, and you can as well. Hey, have a great day. And they're like, oh my word. Thank you so much. And then you go, oh, by the way, So you do like the Columbo close, right? Hey, by the way, I thought I'd run a couple ideas by. Do you think we can grab a coffee or grab a Zoom or chat next week? Oh, yeah. Well, now they're willing to say yes because you didn't cold call them. You gave value first. Right. So to answer your question, my packages are done for you, super powerful, have coaching and accountability mainly just because I am there to get questions that you have. I'm not on you. I'm not, you know, going to be, you know, making you feel bad, but I hand deliver them to you. I do them myself. I coach you with a session on how to implement each one, give you a strategy guide and say, I'm an email away. And of course I've got packages where it's ongoing monthly, but for some of these ones where it's like, I just want to, you know, dip my toe in the water. You know, I've got packages from $500 to $5,000 and up. Right. So anywhere in between, but the main thing is being seen, being noticed for your expert, authority and being able to have your target audience understand that solution you provide to them in a clear way to open up the door for them to, you know, come see you, chat, whatever. Now, again, does that mean you're going to get 100% close ratio? No way. Nobody can guarantee that, but it's going to get you more at bats.
Right. Love it. Love it. Makes complete sense. What is the best way for someone to get a hold of you if they have a question, they want to set up a call or just gather some more information?
So I've got a couple options. One is MikeSaunders360.com. And that's where I put everything about me right on that one little, it's called a 360 site. You can see all my social medias. You can get a free copy of my book called Authority Selling. You can click the contact button and schedule a time to chat with me. So MikeSaunders360.com. If you want to go directly to my website, it's just like my logo here, AuthorityPositioningCoach.com. And then you can see testimonial videos, training videos, you know, all kinds of things that I provide for free. I even have a free Authority Positioning Manifesto, which is a 52-page PDF document, which is pure teaching, no selling. And when you sign up for that, you immediately get it. But also, I give you three video interviews that I did from my Authority Summit a couple years ago. And I interviewed some really top people, Bob Berg, Anthony Annarino, John Rulin. But I give you three of the top interviews just when you sign up for that for free, the Authority Positioning Manifesto.
That's great. That 360 site, by the way, I did take a look at that site. Is that something you would also help with people with? Because that's a nice centralized website that literally covers everything. I was blown away at the site.
Well, you know, the interesting thing, the answer is yes. And the interesting thing is here, it's set up. I'm just going to grab my phone here. So when I click here, I'm going to kind of pull this up when it loads. Okay. So here is, you know, how it looks on my phone. The really cool thing is this. There's a strategic way to use this when you're networking with people. Right. So let's just say that you're doing a presentation or like what I just did here. You know, hey, you want a free copy of my book? Just go to Mike Saunders 360. Well, right here, you can click on, you know, as an example, contact and save contact to the phone and watch what happens. All of a sudden, when you click save contact, the V card automatically will download to your phone. And there are some pre-formatted messages that you would be, if someone was texting you, you could easily, with a press of a button, copy what's called your digital business card and text it to the person and then hit copy again for this message that is all formatted out that goes, hey, great to meet you. You know, wouldn't have your name Giuseppe, but it would be, hey, great to meet you with a thumbs up. Above is my digital business card and below is the link to download my contact so that it's in your phone and I'm there anytime you need me. And all you're doing is going copy, paste, send. So that 360 site, yes, is everything right there, you know, with all your socials. And then I don't need to go, oh, I'm at this or underscore. It's just right there. But it's also a networking relationship building tool that makes communication really neat. So yeah, you can go to Mike Saunders 360 and get all that stuff. But also right there at the bottom somewhere is get a free 360 site and you can get a free version for yourself. Might not have all the bells and whistles that I have on my pro version, but try it out for free and see what you think.
Awesome. I like that. We're doing away with business cards. So I think that's definitely the way of the future. So I gotta definitely check that out. Mike, it was a pleasure. I know this is, you know, I guess the first episode was a quick run, right? A practice run, but we'll do a show on the mistakes I have made, right. I have made in the podcasting world. I, I, have no shame there. And we could talk about mics and all the hangups for why people don't start a show. So again, I appreciate it. This is great. We went live. We're going to test it out to make sure everything worked. And if there are any comments, feel free to leave them on here. You can email Mike. They can go on your website, Mike Saunders 360, or feel free to comment ggthefranchiseguide.com. You can contact me there, and I'll be more than glad to get those questions and comments over to Mike. Once again, Mike, thanks again, and we'll definitely talk soon.
Thanks, Giuseppe.
Take care.